Yo, what's going on, boys? It's your boy Maxi here, and in today's tutorial I'll show you guys a super cool pre-kill build-up effect where the screen sort of zooms in and everything turns red as you just saw in the intro. Let's get straight into it. Okay, so what you obviously need for this tutorial is your clip and your song. Today I'm using the song Mixed Emotions. It's definitely gonna come up, it's gonna turn algorithm very soon, so make sure you check out the artist. This link's gonna be in the description. And yeah, obviously what you want to do first is timer map the clip. For that you just apply your normal Twixer preset or your normal velocity preset, it doesn't really matter. Very, very clean sort of screen pause as you can see right here before the kill, which is definitely gonna look good, so make sure you choose the right clip. And what you want to do now is obviously put on some color correction first of all, which will be basically my normal black and white color correction. As you can see right here, just a normal black and white. You can obviously use MBL for that as well, but I'm not sure about the outcome with this. But yeah, what you really want to do is obviously turn that down on the impact, and that's really it. Just set that to zero, and yeah, make sure it instantly fades in right here. So what we want to do now is basically get the Blurmo Curves plugin, just the default one. Drag that on right here, and what you want to do now is animate the Z disk. You want to go on the impact, obviously make a keyframe, and then it really depends how fast you want the sort of zoom out effect to happen. It can be 5 frames, can be 4 frames, can be 3 frames. I'm just gonna do 5 for now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're gonna make a keyframe and set that to 1.5. As you can see right here, we have this nice little zoom out effect, and yeah, as you can see, sort of cleanly fades out. We're actually gonna fast fade that to make this a bit more excessive, I would say. That's pretty clean. And yeah, what you obviously want to do is set the keyframe before the impact to 1.5 as well, and then just basically instantly set it back. Maybe make that actually 2 frames, might look a bit smoother just for the impact, or maybe actually 3. And yeah, what we want to work now is obviously with the Pinch Punch plugin. Drag on some preset. And then what we want to do, as you can see already, this sort of effects, this clean zoom out effect. And what we want to do is obviously animate it. Go right here, go one before the impact. And then, yeah, basically set that to 0 right here. Make it a slow fade, set that to -1. And then as you can see, you have this nice little build up zoom out effect, which basically zooms in the kill. And yeah, you can also fast or linear fade that, it doesn't really matter. I just prefer this sort of slow fade as it looks pretty clean. To create the RGB, we obviously need universe RGB separation. This is really the only separation that really works for me. But yeah, what you want to do is animate the distortion, and sort of same like the pinch punch, set that to say something like 20, probably should look all right. You can obviously make this a bit more, try fast fade that, and actually make that sort of 50 maybe, really depends. This sort of creates this clean little like RGB effect on the edges, and yeah, in my opinion this already looks very, very good. As you can see, this looks like super clean. And yeah, what we want to do now is obviously create the background. What you want to do for this is obviously you need a track, and you want to drag it under the clip, not above the clip. You want to drag it under the clip, as you can see right now. If you disable everything, then the black and white effect, that the screen is basically under it and it sort of acts like a background. And yeah, what you can do now is obviously add a color correction. I'm just going to use some tritone for this. Just going to drag on this right here and set that to red and make this a pretty dark red, something like this. Kind of looks good in my opinion. Use some film grain right here, BCC film grain, really doesn't matter, and just put that on that one right here, so it creates this sort of little like film grain effect. You want to trim this right here as well. And yeah, as you can see right now, we already have this pretty clean sort of pinch punch build-up effect. And you obviously want to make sure that the background is exactly synced up with the gameplay. So obviously if you use Twixter, the values will still be the same, so nothing changes really. As you can see, the movement of the legs is pretty much synced. Yeah, that's basically already the tutorial. You can obviously now add like a shake or something, and different impact elements, just like a glow for example, glint. I don't really care. Just gonna apply this shake right here. And if you want the shake settings, or any of the other settings, like if you just want this preset in general, you obviously can check out my editing pack. It's gonna be linked down below in the description obviously. And yeah, right there you have all my settings. everything I use. Some nice project files which you just copy and paste those settings out of. Yeah, let me just apply this dissolve shake as well for the impact. So like this, that zero, fast fade that. Now we're actually gonna apply like a slight glint, nothing too crazy. And yeah, when you're done and follow the tutorial correctly, you should have something just like that. Shorty, you got me feeling. Obviously a small pro tip I would say, if you want the audio to sort of match up with the effect on screen, you can obviously right here split the audio track, fade it in for like a bunch of milliseconds. And then you can just apply the resonant filter, just apply the muffled one and play around with it. But if you apply that preset, you should have like a cleanly muffled audio right before the kill, just like that. And yeah, that's already going to be the end of the tutorial. I hope y'all enjoyed this one. If you guys want a Twixer syncing tutorial or like a tutorial on how I build up my sniper effects with all those like crazy effects, you should probably buy my editing pack since these tutorials are included in there. If you have any questions, let me know down below as well. Thank you everyone so much for the support recently. I'm really trying my hardest to keep up with everything. And yeah, I've just been busy with my editing pack recently, so I'm sorry for the lack of uploads on YouTube. I'm trying my best. I'm probably gonna upload another client work on Wednesday if everything works out. And yeah, make sure you follow my Twitter and Instagram if you haven't already. Links are gonna be down below in the description as well. And yeah, make sure you like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. If you want more tutorials, make sure you drop me some ideas down below as well. And yeah, until the next one, have a great day and peace out.